welcome to Manu Law Classes. I am Gautam Dixit, subject matter expert of GK and current affairs. In this video, we are going to discuss the important current affairs of last week from 1st May to 7th May 2021. The topics which we are going to discuss today are the difference between the first wave and second wave. So we will see that how the second wave is different from the first wave. Then we will going to see that can we bring the peak of second wave faster. Peak means a situation from where the number of cases, the number of infections starts decreasing. That is called as peak. Then we will also see that what is this third wave of COVID-19 which is being discussed. Okay, the principal scientific advisor to our prime minister has said that the third COVID wave in India is inevitable, but he has not said that when it will strike India. So he is now of the view that we should be better prepared for the third wave and the situation should not be like what we are witnessing in second wave. Then we will see the medical oxygen crisis in India and we will try to see that the oxygen crisis is mainly due to the availability of oxygen or the transportation of oxygen and how India is solving it, how India is resolving this crisis. Then we will look at bio bubble. Then we will see RBI initiative to revive economy and health. Then we will take up some quiz. We have four flagship courses at Manu Law Classes designed for the maximum productivity and improving your score at law exams. We have DU LLB crash course. Then we have 2-year program for those who have enrolled in 11th standard or those who are going to enroll in 11th standard. Then we have 1-year flexible program you can take for weekday or weekend program for CLAT. It is ideal for those who are studying in 12th standard or if you have passed the 12th standard. Then we have 45 days crash course, especially designed for law exams, quick revision of law exams and to boost your score in the last minute. So these are our flagship courses. You can inquire more about our flagship courses by contacting us at these two numbers. You can mail us at info@manulawclasses.com or you can visit our website lawentranceindia.com to know more about our flagship courses and the facilities which we provide to you at our Manu Law Classes. Now we will proceed to our lecture. Now the first is that how second wave is different from the first wave. So we are going to discuss. So let's have some facts. Now right now India is reporting over as twice as many cases as it did during the first peak or first wave. Okay, in first wave, the highest cases which was recorded for a single day was 97,000 cases in September, October 2020. But as you can see, on April 30, 2021, India crossed 4 lakh cases daily. So means 4 lakh people were tested positive. This is the first difference. The second difference is that in the first wave, it was only few states like Maharashtra, which were badly hit by COVID case. But in the second case, most of the states like Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, Uttar Pradesh, Gujarat, Maharashtra, and Madhya Pradesh, they are recording very high cases. The third important difference is that detection in second wave, detection of corona virus in second wave has become a little tough. Because the new mutant of coronavirus, they are evading the RT-PCR test, which is considered as golden test for COVID. Okay, why this is happening? Because the new corona variant is now residing or is now being detected from the lower respiratory tract, not from the upper respiratory tract. So if the coronavirus in the upper respiratory tract, so the RT-PCR test can identify the coronavirus. But if the virus is in lower respiratory tract, so we have to go for the different test, which is called as bronchoalveolar lavage test. Okay, bronchoalveolar lavage test. Please remember this. The fourth important point is that in the first wave, it were mostly the old people and the people with comorbidities like blood pressure, heart disease, kidney disease, sugar, they were getting infected with the virus. But this in second wave, the new mutant is targeting the young people and children alike. The second is that the number of cases is increasing very fast in the second wave. So the cases are rising very steeply in the second wave. So these are the major differences. Now we will see that how this second wave started. We in December, January, we were about to defeat Corona. Okay, there was a feeling of security that now the Corona will not come back. The vaccination has also arrived. But what happened that now we are experiencing the more severe COVID case, second wave. So like, see, once the vaccine arrived, so there was lack of adherence to COVID norms. The COVID appropriate behavior was not followed by most of the people. We were not wearing masks, we were not using hand sanitizer, and we were not maintaining the social distance. The second reason was pandemic fatigue. What is the meaning of pandemic fatigue? People, they become tired of staying in a home for a longer period of time. They become tired of wearing the mask. They become tired of being isolated from their social groups. That is called as pandemic fatigue. So the moment the lockdown relaxations happens, they just go out and they start socializing. So this is the point of this, is the point where there is very high risk of contracting this disease. The next is lack of effective implementation of containment zone. The first phase, the containment zone policy was very effectively implemented. Containment zone means if some area is showing very large number of positive cases, then that area will be enclosed or that area will be closed off from other area. Okay, so nobody can enter in this area, and from this area nobody can come out. This is called as proper containment zone. But in the second wave, this containment zone policy was not followed properly. Then in the second wave, we have some deadly strains which are circulating in our population. It is, the first is the UK strain, which is called as B.1.1.7. And the next is B.1.617. It is also called as double mutant strain. The double mutant strain was first identified in December 2020 in Nagpur. Okay. And the recent surge in the second wave is attributed to this variant. These variants are also known as variant of concerns. Okay. Then the slow rate of vaccination. The vaccination policy in India followed phases. Then in first phase, only frontline workers were to be inoculated. Then in second phase, anybody above 50 years of age and below 50 years of age, but with comorbidities. And then in third phase, from May 1, now it has been made universal for anyone above 18 years of age. So our vaccination policy was very slow. We could not vaccinate very large number of people. The next is immunity from the first phase was not widespread. Now, this is very important. What happened in widespread? Very less number of people were infected, and most of the people were following the COVID appropriate behavior. So very less number of people, they contracted the disease. Now, once very less number of people are contracting the disease, it means what? Very few people will be in the country who have developed the immune system which can fight against Corona. So when the second wave struck, the people who were earlier contracted with Corona, they got little safer, but most of the people, they didn't have any immune system. And second, they were not vaccinated. So they were the easy target for Corona. Now, the next question is that, can we do something? Can we bring the peak in second wave faster? So what is the meaning of peak? Let's understand. So suppose these are number of days and these are cases. So what happens earlier when the infection starts, the case goes on rising. Okay. But as the case is going on increasing, government is also taking every step to control the disease. So a point will be reached when the government efforts and the citizen effort will start showing up, and the disease will start decreasing. So the point from where the disease started decreasing, suppose it is A, then this point A will be called as peak. Now, can we bring this peak? It means, can we bring the day when the COVID cases will start falling down? So we have three strategies. If we follow the three strategies, we can bring this COVID cases down. The first is aggressive containment strategy. Okay, one of the main reasons for the second wave of corona is that we did not follow the containment strategy properly. But if we follow the aggressive containment strategy once again, so we can break the chain of transmission. Then we should not go for a nationwide lockdown, but we should go for a localized lockdown. So wherever the disease reporting is very high, we should ensure lockdown only in those areas. Lockdown should be imposed only there. And the third and very important thing is COVID appropriate behavior. Now, what is COVID appropriate behavior? Three are very fundamental COVID appropriate behavior. One is wearing the mask. Second is sanitizing and washing the hand regularly. And third is maintaining the social distance. Do gaj ki duri, mask hai zaruri. Ye hamare hote hain COVID appropriate behavior. तो अगर हम इन तीन चीजों को फॉलो करते हैं फ्रेंड्स, तो हम सेकेंड कोरोना वेव को भी हरा सकते हैं. ओके, सिर्फ सरकार की जिम्मेदारी नहीं है, हम सब एज अ रेस्पॉन्सिबल सिटीजन, हम सब की जिम्मेदारी है कि हम कोविड एप्रोप्रिएट बिहेवियर फॉलो करें और जल्दी से जल्दी सेकेंड कोरोना वेव को कंट्रोल में लाएं. अच्छा, अब हम आते हैं थर्ड वेव पे. ओके, हमारे प्रिंसिपल साइंटिफिक एडवाइजर हैं, उन्होंने रिसेंटली स्टेटमेंट दिया है और बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेटमेंट है. द नेम ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल साइंटिफिक एडवाइजर इज श्री के विजय राघवन. ओके, नाउ ही हैज सेड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. व्हाट ही हैज सेड इज दैट द थर्ड वेव ऑफ कोरोना इज इनएविटेबल. इनएविटेबल मतलब कि हम इससे बच नहीं सकते. एंड नाउ ही हैज गिवन द रीजन व्हाई द थर्ड वेव इज इनएविटेबल. ही इज सेइंग बिकॉज देयर इज वेरी हाई अमाउंट ऑफ वायरस इन सर्कुलेशन. अब इसका मतलब क्या होता है? फॉर एग्जाम्पल, नाउ इसका मतलब ये है कि एज यू कैन सी कि सेकेंड वेव में इंफेक्शन बहुत ज्यादा लोगों को हुआ है. ठीक है, फाइन. सो समझो कि पिछली बार सिर्फ 1% लोगों को कोरोना हुआ था, इस बार 10% लोगों को कोरोना हुआ है. ओके, बट ट्राई टू थिंक लाइक दिस, बट स्टिल 90% पीपल आर दोज हु आर नॉट इन्फेक्टेड विद कोरोना. फाइन, नाउ इन फर्स्ट फेज इफ यू विल सी only 1% people were there who could spread the corona. Got it? But now this has multiplied by 10. Now it is now around 10% people are there who can infect any number of people from this 90%. Okay, so it means that since now higher number of people are infected from the virus, okay, so they can transmit the virus to the higher population. And then, and if we lower our guard, so soon the third wave will come. The next thing which he has told is that we cannot predict at this point of time that when the third wave will strike. Okay, but definitely he has said that there is one thing very sure, that the third wave, in third wave we will have some different mutant virus. We will not have same mutant. We will not have same mutant virus. The virus will change itself. It will go under mutation. Okay, if the virus goes under mutation, तो क्या होगा कि जो हमारा immune system है वो उसको evade कर जाएगा, या जो हमारा अभी का vaccine है उसका जो protection mechanism है उसको evade कर जाएगा. Okay, so if the virus goes under mutation, so now what will happen? Again, we can have the same problem. The surge in cases is very high. More number of people are getting infected. And जो अभी हम देख रहे हैं कि RT-PCR test जो है वो corona को पकड़ नहीं पा रहा है. Okay, we are coming with different test so that we can detect the corona. ऐसे सारे cases होने की संभावना बहुत ज्यादा है. Okay, so now he says that the only thing which is in our hand to fight the third wave is that we should follow the COVID appropriate behavior. The second is that since the virus जो है वो अपना mutation कर जाएगा, वो अपने property को change कर जाएगा, तो हमको vaccine को भी upgrade करना पड़ेगा ताकि वो उस नए virus के साथ फाइट कर सके. सो वी शुड गो फॉर वैक्सीन अपग्रेडेशन एज वायरस कैन अंडरगो द म्यूटेशन. द थर्ड इज द टाइम ऑफ थर्ड वेव कैनॉट बी प्रेडिक्टेड. द टाइम ऑफ थर्ड वेव कैनॉट बी प्रेडिक्टेड. ये तीन इंपॉर्टेंट चीजें हैं, अगर हम इसको ध्यान में रखते हैं, सो वी कैन फाइट द थर्ड वेव बिफोर इट अपीयर्स. ओके, अब दोस्तों आते हैं, हम थोड़ा सा ऑक्सीजन क्राइसिस को समझने के लिए आते हैं कि व्हाट इज दिस ऑक्सीजन क्राइसिस. नाउ बिफोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द ऑक्सीजन क्राइसिस वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द लॉजिस्टिक. ओके, लॉजिस्टिक मींस व्हाट आर द प्रोसेस इन्वॉल्व्ड फ्रॉम इंडस्ट्री टू द हॉस्पिटल फॉर ट्रांसपोर्टिंग द ऑक्सीजन. ओके, तो हम इंडस्ट्री में ऑक्सीजन, मेडिकल ऑक्सीजन बनाते हैं जो 95% जिसकी प्योरिटी होती है. ओके, its purity is 99.5%. then it is filled in jumbo tankers. these jumbo tankers, okay, ye jumbo tankers ko mein fill kiye jate hain, fir cryogenic tankers mein hum unko jumbo tankers mein fill kar diya jata hai. fir agar humko transport karna hai, then we use cryogenic tankers. what is the meaning of cryogenic tankers? the cryogenic tankers are those tankers where the temperature inside the tanker will be around -180°C. -180°C, इतने कम टेम्परेचर पे द गैशियस ऑक्सीजन जो होता है वो लिक्विड में ट्रांसफॉर्म हो जाती है, इसीलिए हम उसको कहते हैं लिक्विड ऑक्सीजन. फाइन, वी कैन नॉट ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑक्सीजन इन अ गैशियस फॉर्म. व्हाई? बिकॉज ऑक्सीजन इज इनफ्लेमेबल मटेरियल, इनफ्लेमेबल गैस, बहुत जल्दी आग पकड़ लेगा, तो उसको हम लिक्विड में स्टोर करते हैं. सेकेंड, लिक्विड में उसको स्टोर करते हैं तो क्या होता है कि इफ यू आर ट्रांसपोर्टिंग समथिंग, सम गैस इन अ फॉर्म ऑफ लिक्विड, सो यू कैन ट्रांसपोर्ट लार्जर अमाउंट ऑफ लिक्विड. ओके, बाद में अगर आपको जरूरत है तो उसको गैस में ट्रांसफॉर्म कर सकते हो. फाइन, सो द कैपेसिटी टू ट्रांसपोर्ट इंक्रीजेस. फाइन, एक बार जब वो डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर के पास पहुंच जाता है, ठीक है, तो वो क्या करेंगे, लिक्विड ऑक्सीजन को फिर से गैस में कन्वर्ट करेंगे. उस प्रोसेस को कहते हैं रीगैसिफिकेशन. ओके, एक बार रीगैसिफिकेशन होने के बाद उसको हम जंबो सिलेंडर्स जो डिफरेंट कैपेसिटीज में आती हैं और डूरा सिलेंडर्स में फिल करते हैं, और फिर हम उसको स्मॉल डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स या डायरेक्टली हॉस्पिटल्स में ट्रांसपोर्ट करते हैं. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड इन सेकेंड कोरोना वेव. अब सेकेंड वेव में ऐसा क्या हो गया, सेकेंड वेव में देखिए व्हाट हैपेंड. सेकेंड वेव में हुआ क्या कि द इंफेक्शन रेट ऑफ सेकेंड वेव इज वेरी हाई. ओके, सो वेरी लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ पीपल स्टार्टेड रीचिंग हॉस्पिटल एट वंस, एंड देन द डिमांड फॉर ऑक्सीजन इंक्रीज वेरी हाई इन वेरी शॉर्ट स्पैन ऑफ टाइम. ठीक है, अब होता क्या है, सपोज हर जगह ऑक्सीजन नहीं बनता. सपोज द लार्जेस्ट मैन्युफैक्चरर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इज हियर एंड द ऑक्सीजन इज नाउ रिक्वायर्ड इन दिल्ली. फाइन, सो दिस ऑक्सीजन हैज टू बी ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू दिल्ली. सो दिस ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, नाउ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन कैनॉट हैपन इन एनी टाइप ऑफ ट्रक. दिस रिक्वायर स्पेशल क्रायोजेनिक टैंकर्स. ओके, वी रिक्वायर स्पेशल क्रायोजेनिक टैंकर्स टू ट्रांसपोर्ट इट. Now there was a shortage of cryogenic tankers as well. तो अब एक बार shortage हो गई cryogenic tankers की, तो फिर क्या हुआ कि यहां से गुजरात से दिल्ली पहुंचने में काफी time लग गया oxygen को. Okay, and then there was a shortage. What it? So this is the problem. Transportation of oxygen within time is problem. और ये क्यों हो रहा है, क्योंकि जो distribution network है oxygen का वो अच्छे से develop नहीं हुआ है. हमारे पास शॉर्टेज है, टैंकर्स का भी शॉर्टेज है, हमारे पास हर चीज का गाड़ियों का शॉर्टेज है. ओके, गॉट इट. सो दिस वाज द मेन रीजन. ओके, सो सी द डिमांड इज वेरी हाई बट देयर इज शॉर्टेज ऑफ सिलेंडर्स, टैंकर्स टू स्टोर एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट द ऑक्सीजन. द सेकेंड इज ट्रांसपोर्टिंग द ऑक्सीजन विच इज इनफ्लेमेबल इज चैलेंजिंग, स्पेशली इन रिमोट एंड रूरल एरियाज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिल्ली तो चलो जल्दी से पहुंच सकता है, बट देयर मे बी सम रिमोट एरिया इन मध्य प्रदेश नाउ फ्रॉम वेयर दे विल गेट द टैंकर्स और द ऑक्सीजन. सो दिस वॉज द मेजर प्रॉब्लम. ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, प्रोडक्शन वॉज ऑल्सो अ प्रॉब्लम, बट ट्रांसपोर्टेशन वॉज ऑल्सो अ मेजर प्रॉब्लम रिगार्डिंग विद रिगार्ड टू दिस थिंग. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी वॉट इज हैपनिंग इन द करेंट सिचुएशन. Now see, the new strain is infecting 30 people in 72 hours. Means the rise in the cases is very steep. Suppose in previous cases, if the rise was happening like this, so in these cases, the rise is happening almost like this, very steep. Okay, so now the rise is very high. So the oxygen demand has multiplied 4 times, okay, in second surge. So in second phase, the oxygen demand has increased to 6,600 metric ton from 1,200 metric ton of first phase. Okay, at the same time, what is happening now in corona, what happens if people get panic, even if they have good level of oxygen? For example, India recommends, the Ministry of Health recommends that if the oxygen level is up to 93, it is good. If it is 93 or below 93, then only you require hospitalization. And if it is below 90, then only you require ICU. But people having healthy level of oxygen also, they get panic and they rush to the hospital, creating the scarcity. अब हम इसको सॉल्व कैसे करें इस प्रॉब्लम को? जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इज वन ऑफ द मेजर प्रॉब्लम. ओके, सो सपोज इफ दिल्ली रिक्वायर्स, सपोज दिल्ली इज देयर, मुंबई इज देयर, ओके, लखनऊ इज देयर, दे ऑल रिक्वायर ऑक्सीजन, फाइन, बट प्रोडक्शन सिर्फ यहीं पे हो रहा है. सो द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इज टेकिंग टाइम, सो व्हाट वी कैन डू, व्हाई नॉट टू डू समथिंग सो दैट ऑक्सीजन इज प्रोड्यूस हियर ओनली. ऑक्सीजन इज प्रोड्यूस नियर दिल्ली ओनली. Oxygen is produced near Mumbai only. So the government has come up with the concept of called as pressure swing absorption technique. We will discuss what this technique is. That let's establish pressure swing absorption techniques in remote area. Let every district have PSA plant, pressure swing absorption technique. Okay, now who will be doing the civil work of this PSA plant? The site will be selected by Ministry of Health, and the plant will be constructed by National Highway Authority of India, each, okay, within 15 days limit. This is very important. NHAI will be constructing the PSA within 15 days limits. The second option is that hospitals should set up huge storage tanks. Fine. At the same time, we can use special trains called as Oxygen Express and airways to transport the oxygen from far-flung areas to the required place. Fine. Then surplus oxygen, which is used in iron and steel industry, they can be diverted to medical use. Then we are using cryogenic tankers for argons and nitrogen. We can divert it for using for oxygen. At the same time, the Ministry of Health has floated a tender for procuring the 50,000 tons of medical oxygen. So these are the steps which have been taken by the government to resolve the oxygen crisis. Now, this is the technique of PSA, pressure swing absorption technique. So see, here from here, we have air receiver receiving the air. Then it is being dried through cooling. Then this is air filter, like all the impurities are being removed. Now our air contains nitrogen and oxygen in a very high proportion. So now most of the gases are being removed. Okay. And then this is the chamber from where you can see that oxygen, now whatever air we require, for example, if we require nitrogen air, so from here, carbon dioxide and oxygen present in the air will be removed. Okay. And the nitrogen will be received. I mean, even if we require oxygen, then nitrogen will be removed, carbon dioxide will be removed, and then we will receive oxygen, which will be the dry oxygen. So this is called as pressure swing absorption technique. Okay, here the gas which we require, it will be absorbed, and rest of the gas will be released in the atmosphere. Very simple hai. Ki nitrogen hai, oxygen hai, carbon dioxide hai gas mein, humne sara gas liya, humko sirf oxygen chahiye. We remove nitrogen and carbon dioxide through pressure swing absorption technique, and we got the pure oxygen of at least 95% purity. Now, the recent RBI initiative. Now, what RBI has done to resolve this crisis, this health sector crisis? The first is the RBI has opened up a liquidity window of rupees 50,000 crore at repo rate for health sector. It means the commercial banks can lend to health sector at very cheap interest rate. How much amount? Rupees 50,000 crore. The second is the health sector will be treated as priority sector lending. Priority sector lending, I will just explain you in the short. There are certain sectors like education, renewable energy, agriculture, export, housing, social infrastructure, which are considered as priority sector lending by RBI. Once any sector is designated as priority sector lending, then 40% of the total credit given by commercial and foreign bank should go to priority sector lending. Okay. And if that bank is regional rural bank or cooperative bank or small finance bank, then 75% of their credit should go to the priority sector lending. Okay. Now see, the small finance banks have been allowed to borrow rupees 10,000 crore for lending to small and retail businesses. Okay. And each borrower will get rupees 10 lakh of loan. Now, small businesses, MSMEs and individuals can restructure their loans and obligations. Okay. Means if they have payment to be due, they can restructure it. Okay. They can discuss it with the bank and they can restructure their loan. The only condition is that they should not have availed the earlier restructuring schemes. Fine. Then I have already discussed in the last lecture that RBI has come up with the government security acquisition program. इसमें आरबीआई क्या करने वाली है, इसमें आरबीआई जो है वो बॉन्ड के थ्रू रुपीज 1 लाख करोड़ रुपीज रेज करने वाली है. तो एक फेज हो चुका है, सेकेंड फेज होने वाला है ऑफ रुपीज 35,000 करोड़. सो आरबीआई इज गोइंग टू रेज रुपीज 35,000 करोड़ बाय सेलिंग बॉन्ड इन दी ओपन मार्केट. अच्छा, उसके बाद फॉर स्टेट गवर्नमेंट द ओवरड्राफ्ट पीरियड, मीन्स ओवरड्राफ्ट मीन्स द मनी विच एनीबडी कैन बोरो अबव द लिमिट. It is called as overdraft. So the overdraft period of the states has been increased from 35 days to 50 days. From 35 days to 50 days. Okay. So these are the steps taken by RBI to revive the economy during such a tough time. Okay. Now the last topic, what is biosecure bubble? So see, the biosecure bubble, the bubble means what? It is a safe and secure environment from COVID-19. Okay, safe and secure environment from COVID-19. And how we maintain that safety? The restriction, there will be restriction of entry and movement of the people in that bubble. For example, there will be designated place. Okay, suppose this is the hotel. So here what will happen? It will be treated as bubble. So whosoever is entering or leaving this place, there will be restrictions imposed on them. Only those people will be allowed to enter, those who have tested negative for COVID. Okay. And the people who, if anyone goes out, fine, then he will be allowed to come only if he again test negative. So this is called as bubble. Okay. So what is the advantage? It minimizes the risk of transmission of disease. Okay. Now it was initiated for sporting events like the US Open, now recently the IPL, but in IPL the bubble has been breached. Okay. So the bubble gets breached. If anybody makes the interaction with outer world or enters the undemarcated zone where that person is not entitled to go, then the bubble breaks, and then the members who are in this bubble, they can get infected with the disease. The same thing which happened with the players who were playing for IPL, and the IPL got indefinitely postponed. Now let's have quiz. The first is Chiranjeevi Health Insurance Scheme is launched by which state? So Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Telangana, none of the above. So the answer is very simple. The answer is Rajasthan. The scheme was launched on 1st May 2021. Okay. We will discuss the detailed answer. Which country has recently authorized the Pfizer vaccine for the inoculation of children up to 12 years? So let's see the answer for both of this. Yeah. So see, the Chiranjeevi is the health insurance scheme of Rajasthan government. It aims to provide rupees 5 lakh health insurance to each family. Then Canada has recently authorized the Pfizer vaccine for the inoculation of children up to 12 years. Up to 12 years. Okay. One more information. Sputnik Light has been introduced by Russia. It will be only one jab or one dose vaccine. It will be only one dose vaccine. So Sputnik 5 is two dose vaccine, but Sputnik Light is only one dose vaccine. So please remember it. Now, who is the chairperson of the National Commission for Women? The correct answer is Rekha Sharma. The next is, which country recently abolished death penalty? Or simply, which African country recently abolished the death penalty? So the answer is Malawi. So here is the answer, little in detail, that Ms. Rekha Sharma is the chairperson of National Commission for Women. The National Commission for Women was established under the National Commission for Women Act 1990. Recently, the Supreme Court of Malawi, which is a country in Africa, recently abolished the death penalty, saying that it is against the right to life. The next is, who is the president of BCCI, Board of Cricket Control of India? The answer is Sourav Ganguly. Which country is not the member of G7? The answer is Russia. Okay, so see, the president of BCCI is Sourav Ganguly. The vice president is Sri Rajiv Shukla, and the secretary is Mr. Jay Shah. Now, who are the members of G7, group of seven? All the developed industrialized nations like Italy, France, Germany, United States, United Kingdom, Japan, and Canada. You can see there is one Asian country also in G7, which is Japan. Now, again, our flagship courses, DULLB Crash Course, 1 year program, 2 year program, and 45 days crash course, our flagship courses. You can obtain more information by mailing us at info@manulawclasses.com, or you can call us at these two numbers, or you can visit our website, lawentranceindia.com. Please subscribe to our channel, and hope you must have liked this video and you must have found it very informative. You can follow more videos on English, legal aptitude, and legal maxims more by following our channel. Thank you for watching this video.